Hello, I'm Selma Teacher 7, also known as Mr. Barry by my students, and today is day number 30 for the A+ curriculum, also known as the Network Control Operator class. Now, we have just a few more weeks of class left, and what we do normally towards the end is we build a nice computer in class. Just to let you know for the viewers, these are free computer classes that we offer at the Kings Canyon Adult School here in Reedley, Selma, and also up in Dunlap. Today, we're going to be looking at the parts that make up a modern PC. So we're going to have some nice parts to show off today. First off is the Core i5 Intel processor here. Now, this one is the i5-7500. And the information is there for the price. Going with that one. And so what do you get in the box? Well, let's actually open this up. Normally I never open these until right as I'm installing them and building the computer system. But hey, this is special. This is on video. So let's show this off here. What do you get? Ooh. Okay, you get a booklet inside here, installation guide, which we'll use there in class. And there's the actual processor right there. And let's look at the heat sink. There's part of the fan, and then the heat sink is here. You want to make sure that you don't touch this area right here. This is the part that will make contact with your CPU's heat spreader. And there's the CPU, and the heat spreader is right there. It's that flat, shiny part. Okay, this is kind of like a small heat sink compared to what I've seen in the past. But this is the 7th generation, so I'm excited about working with that. Next, we're going to look at RAM. Now, I actually bought two different sticks of memory because I'm going to test to see what the difference is in performance between 8 and 16 gigs of DDR4 memory. See, is there really a difference in the things that an average user may do, or even someone who may really stress it? So you can see those options there on the screen. And so this is DDR4 memory. Let me open up one of these. See, I'm opening up the 8 gig version of the DDR4. This is the speed of the 2400. Kind of has a nice heat spreader on it, and this one lights up. See where you can actually see it'll be an LED light. Interesting. That is that there. Next, the main drive. Now for the main drive, I'm going to be using the M.2, and here it is in this box. So what do we have? Ooh, the Intel SSD 6. Alright, get the feels like Christmas all over again. Let's open this one up here. Okay, so break through there. Now this is 128 gig as the information on your screen shows. And I went that one because of the budget. We had a budget to go on that was somewhere between $400 and $1,000. So that's there. M.2, and this is using the PCI Express as the way mode of transferring data. Exciting. For the secondary drive, I went with a 2 terabyte solid state drive. There. And so So all your data, your main programs could be stored on this one. And your operating system and maybe a few of the programs and frequently used data could be stored here, because this is very, very fast. So I expect the machine to boot up in seconds there. But as far as storing all of the videos I produce and all the data and all the big programs that we install, well, they could be on this 2 terabyte drive. Hopefully that's large enough for all the work that I do. That'll be exciting, bring that one in. The next thing that we have is the motherboard. And I went with the MSI B250M GamingPro. And so you get to have the unboxing. This comes with its own mouse, which lights up, by the way, in red colors. There's some information on it. Let's unbox this and see what we have here. Ooh, exciting, exciting. Let's see, ooh, there it is. That's the motherboard. Let's bring out the motherboard first. Now, like I said, I normally unwrap this only when I'm installing it in a machine, but this is special. Okay. There you go. That is the main board. You can see this is where I'm going to be putting it, installing the Intel Core i5 processor. The RAM will be here. This is PCI Express. If I wanted to install a high-end video card, that's where it go. I didn't go with this particular build to go with that because of the budget constraints, but you can see that's right where it would be. And this board comes with 6-phase power design. And this has been upgraded, as you can see, from last year. And also the logo has changed from the last year. We look over here, we have the standard 24-pin power connector. Then we have SATA. And there's more SATA connections, more SATA ports. I also have PCI Express. But this is 1X. This would be like a Wi-Fi card. Other types of cards could be placed here. And let's now look at the back of the board. Very interesting configuration. When I saw this, I just was very surprised. It has PS2 keyboard and mouse, which we haven't used for quite a while. And then I have VGA up here. And then this is DVI. So these are 2 different types of video outs. This would be for an older monitor. The old style monitor would be VGA. And then this is DVI, which also it's not the newest, but I do have HDMI out. And then I have USBs and USB 3.1. And look at that, there's USB 3.1 there. That's exciting. And then I have audio out. So that is going to be a fun build when we build this in class. Let's see what else is in the box. Ooh, I got a mouse here. Let's pull it out of the box. Let's see what we have here. Okay. Let's open this up. Like I said, it feels like Christmas all over again. Special MSI mouse. Let's plug this into power and see what it looks like. Look at that. It's got a dragon on it. Ooh, look at that dragon right there, huh? And you have other LED lights here on the sides. It's gonna be exciting. People often ask, they say, Mr. Barry, what games do you play now that you have a gaming setup? I go, whoa, I love solitaire. Yeah, I don't really play games. I usually just produce videos, and that stresses my computers enough there. Besides solitaire, I do like Minecraft, and I also play Clash of Clans. So those are all the games I play. Let's see what else is in the box. So let's open this up. Ooh. We have a quick installation guide, which is kind of neat. And then we also have drivers and utility DVD. And the in-depth book. Look at all the pages. But guess what? Only the first 20 pages are in English. So if you want to see in English, you think it's this part is in English and the rest is in the other languages? No, 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 no. It's much smaller than that. Let's go all the way down to English where it stops. There we go. This is the part that's in English, the first 20 pages. The other 180 pages or so, or more than that, you can see the difference there if I bring it like that. That's all the other languages that you have. That's the book that goes with it. It was like a miniature Bible. Let's look at the back plate. Look at the nice design that they have there for the back plate. Can you see that there? Hopefully it's in focus. If not, I'll have to take another picture. But that is a nice design there. That will be seen on the case. And then, of course, you get your SATA cables. You have two of them. And the reason why there's only two and not maybe four or more is because we just don't use that many SATA devices as we did in the past. Now I do have this 2 terabyte drive. This is using that. And if I wanted to go with an optical drive, I might go that way too. But I'm not going with an optical drive for this build. I'm just going to go everything with installing the operating system from a USB storage device. The last part that I have for all the stuff that goes in the case is the Encore wireless USB adapter. And let's look and see this one here. Now, just to let you know, many of the motherboards do come with their own onboard Wi-Fi, but this one does not. Now, many of the Wi-Fi adapters that you can buy now are way smaller than this, or smaller than your pinky. They don't stick out of the back very often, very much. Next is the case. Ooh, I'm using the super case, and I'll have the information up there for you on that one as well. There it is. So those are all the parts that go into the modern PC that we'll be building here in class. So we're gonna have a lot of fun building that thing. Please, as always, rate, comment down below, and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already. And if you notice, I also have a Patreon page that you can go in. If you like videos like this, you can help support me by going there and making a small donation. That would be wonderful, and I would be very much appreciative of that. Thank you again, and bye-bye.